This is Matt Russell, and welcome to the Daily FX Forum.
So here are the four pairs that I will be discussing this evening: the Euro Pound, the Aussie Kiwi, the Pound Swiss, and the Euro Swiss. So let's go ahead and pull up the charts. The first chart is the Euro Pound. If you recall, during yesterday's report, I mentioned the potential for an evening star reversal pattern. Let me zoom in here, give you a better view. And I mentioned that if prices do take out the high of this doji candle right here, which is about 90.39, that would be a reason to exit the trade. And prices were at about this level, 90.19, when I did mention that trade setup. So if you did enter that trade, you were stopped out with a 20 to 25 pip loss. I believe I said to place a stop maybe 90.45 or 90.47 in that area. So moving forward now, I really don't see anything favorable in terms of risk reward setting up, and I'm just going to give this another day, see how this daily candle plays out over the next 24 hours. The next chart is the Aussie Kiwi, and not much has changed here. Price is still rallying. Something that I have noticed, and this could be the potential of my amateur Elliott wave count here, of a third of a third. I just see a 1-2, 1-2, and this is clearly corrective, right? This move right here. So this would be for more aggressive traders. I like this line here, which is about the 26, let's call it 2680, 2670 area, and the previous high as well, which is right here, which is about the same price area as well. And now that prices have closed above it, that this is something that I would look at over the next 24 hours. I might wait for this daily candle to close right now, but again, if this is the third of a third, this thing could really take off and certainly target these highs up here near the 129 area. The next chart is the Pound Swiss, and this again is just the inverse of the Euro Pound. The same thing here, except it was a Morningstar, the potential for a Morningstar reversal pattern, and prices did take out the low here. So again, the Pound Swiss is a little more volatile, so you might have had a 50 pip stop on this trade if you did enter this rather than the Euro Pound. I mentioned yesterday, you know, it was one or the other. And again, right now I really don't see anything setting up, and I'm just going to give it another 24 hours, see how this daily candle plays out. Euro Swiss, again, I'm on the sidelines on this pair, but we could see that this previous support line is clearly acting as resistance, and prices have sold off once again after hitting it. So if you're in that trade, I would continue to stay in this trade until prices have violated this line, and that would be confirmed with a close above the level. But again, I'm on the sidelines. And the next chart is the Euro Aussie, and I mentioned during yesterday's report the potential for a inverse head and shoulder pattern forming here, and that would be about the 60-70 area, waiting for prices to come down there. Maybe call it about 60-75, or, you know, again, these are very general areas. Maybe even just the one, when prices get down to 161, if you will, that's when you start paying attention for this potential trade setup. So moving forward now, I did want to zoom in a little bit and maybe highlight what could materialize as a shorter term range, using the high of this doji candle right here at about the 63.59 area, and again this white line down here, which is about the 160.70 area. So that's something, and right now obviously it's very early for that range to form, and that's usually a very good time to establish these ranges. So again, it's not something that I see with a lot of evidence, just in my mind's eye, something that can certainly materialize over the next few weeks. So something to look for right now, though. With that being said, prices are directly in the middle of that range, and when that occurs, you know, there are no trade setups. So again, I would wait for either prices to rally up to that resistance level or down to that support level where we would look to enter the trades. Again, this is Matt Russell. Thanks for listening, and please stay tuned for a preview of the Daily FX Forums. I want to take this opportunity to formally welcome you all to the Daily FX Forums. I want to go through the process of how I personally access the forums, and how maybe you at home, if you want to access the forums in the future, might do so. The first thing you would do is go to www.dailyfx.com, and that will bring up, obviously, dailyfx.com. And usually there on the upper right-hand corner, I'll go ahead and click on where it says Forum, and that will bring up the first page of the forums. And this view, I personally don't use this view, but this view actually shows you the most recent posts on all the threads within the different sections, and a little detail about those posts, so you can read through and see if something, you know, catches your interest. But Personally, I go ahead and just click on forums and view them in the more traditional sense. Now, these are different threads within the forum. There's a section on education, such as Daily FX course instructor tips, which would be good for newer traders. And then for more advanced traders, and I just want to go ahead, you know, personally, the way I use the forums is I would go through the individual threads, just looking for trade ideas, maybe looking at charts, looking at certain lines that maybe I didn't put up on my chart, but another trader might have put up on their chart. I tend to, you know, shy away from using direct trade recommendations from other forum members, but it helps me to sort of even out my analysis, make sure that I'm seeing things, you know, with the right mind in terms of, you know, I might be missing stuff that other traders can see, and that's, you know, my personal way of using the forum. You know, every trader is going to be a little bit different in how they use it. So if you want to ask questions, if you want to become an active participant of the members, you would have to go ahead and register. So that's what I'm going to go through now, is the registration process. So assuming you're brand new to the forums, or maybe you've been here a few times and you're not really sure how it works, so I just want to walk through again the registration process. This would be the front page where you would access, or the previous page. You'd have the same little box here on the left hand side. My username and password are already filled out here, but assuming you're a new member, you would click on where it says register, and that will bring up the registration page. If you give me one moment here while my browser loads. And actually, first we're going to have some terms of service and Daily FX forum rules. I do suggest reading through the forum rules. Obviously, you know, profanity and spam and things like that are not allowed, but it also gives you insight on, you know, how to use the forum and how different traders can use it, you know, in terms of their individual needs. So you would go down to the bottom there, you'd click on where it says I have read all the rules, and then you would go ahead to the register, the formal registration page, and that will bring up here. And you can go ahead and select the username, and how about we'll use 4X, and that name is already in use, so maybe add a few more X's there. Again, it really, you know, your individual username is up to you, and you go ahead and fill in your password, your email address. Now, the most difficult aspect of registration for the Daily FX forums will be figuring out these letters in the box here. Now, I'm a semi-intelligent person, but I have a very difficult time figuring out which letters and numbers to use. Now, there is a reason for this madness. It helps with security, but I would suggest just going ahead and keep on clicking that refresh image until something comes through that you can actually identify and see. Then you can go ahead and enter your birthday, but you can decide whether or not to display that to other forum members. And then also, if you were referred by somebody, you can enter that information there. The time zone, that should default to your computer, but you should, you know, double check and make sure. And then you can opt in, and I would, you know, suggest opting in for these emails in terms if the administrators want to go ahead and send you some notices about the forum. And then you would complete registration. Now what happens is they would send you an email to the email address that you put up here, and that email will include a link, and all you would have to do is go ahead and click on that link, and that link will bring you inside the forum, and you would now be a member of the Daily FX forums. Again, this is Matt Russell. Thanks for listening.